Hey, what's going on, Guardians? TBL here, and today we're going to be bringing you guys a very quick look at the brand new exotic hand cannon brought to us in The Curse of Osiris, the Crimson. This thing dropped with the DLC and it's been making a lot of noise within the community. And I was able to get my hands on one to bring you guys a quick review. First off, big shout out to my friend Black Fox who let me use his account to get the footage that you're seeing here with the Crimson. But alright, let's go ahead and jump on into this thing. The Crimson is a very unique exotic hand cannon that can drop from any exotic engrams. And it's become a pretty sought after item due to its great overall base stats as well as its fantastic intrinsic and special perks. And as many Guardians have taken note of, this gun aesthetically is very, very heavily based off of the Red Death of old, back from Destiny 1. Red Death was an exotic pulse rifle in Destiny 1 that had a very special ability. Kills with that weapon restored your health and shields to max, and precision kills allowed you to reload faster. And the Crimson is coming with a very similar ability. This weapon's intrinsic perk is called Banned Weapon, where it fires a 3-round burst. That's right, this gun is actually kind of like a pulse hand cannon. It fires a 3-round burst rather than a single shot, making it unique from every other hand cannon in the history of Destiny. It's very interesting. It's also got small bore for increased range and increased stability, accurized rounds for further increased range, and its special ability is called Cruel Remedy, where kills with this weapon will heal the wielder, and precision kills will also refill the magazine. This is a fantastic overall perk for this hand cannon, as it allows you to reliably heal yourself upon getting kills, and if you're precise, you're getting those precision shots, you're going to be refilling your magazine so you can just keep on shooting. It's super helpful in PvE, and it's surprisingly useful in PvP. This, mixed with the 3-round burst, gives this gun a truly unique feel. And of course, it's also got a heavy grip for increased stability and decreased handling speed. So those are the weapon perks, and they're fantastic. But how does this weapon stack up stat-wise? Well, it's actually looking pretty good there. It actually compares pretty favorably to everybody's favorite Crucible hand cannon, the Better Devils, boasting better impact, range, much better stability, and better reload speed. Additionally, its impact tier also matches that of the True Prophecy, still granting better range, stability, and reload speed than that weapon as well. The Crimson's got an aim assist stat of 75 with a recoil direction of 55. So despite the gun's high stability, it's still going to kick to the side a little, so you might benefit from having at least a single kinetic counterbalance mod attached to it. Now overall, I really like the Crimson. It's a very unique weapon with a great exotic ability that, in my opinion, is more like the exotics we had back in D1 rather than the exotics we've got in D2 right now. The ability to heal yourself mid-battle and even restore parts of your magazine when you get precision kills definitely comes in handy in both PvE and PvP. But it is important to note that the health regeneration ability from the Crimson isn't the same as like the Devour ability on Voidwalkers. It's not going to instantly put you back at max health with max shield. What it does is it starts a very speedy health regeneration that will take about a second or so, but push you back to max health. And of course, while I would have preferred the year one Red Death sort of devour ability of instantly getting all of your health back, it doesn't really make too much of a difference. When you get that health regen, it doesn't take long for your health to reach back to maximum, and it's definitely helpful in a lot of situations in PvP and PvE. Especially in PvE when you've got a lot of adds that you'll be facing down. This thing is going to fire forever, well, until it runs out of ammo eventually, but you're going to be getting your health back fairly quickly and fairly often, so you get a lot of utility out of this particular ability in both game modes. Although I have to say, I actually preferred this gun in PvP over PvE. In PvE, for whatever reason, it just feels like you're constantly running out of ammo with it. You know, you've got a 24-round magazine, and you run through that pretty quickly, and even if you're getting those precision kills and reloading that magazine, you're gonna run out of reserves faster than you might expect with this gun. That 3-round burst chews through ammo pretty quickly, but thankfully this gun's got a really fast reload speed for hand cannons. So when you do run out of ammo, you get right back into the action very quickly. Now, in PvP, this gun is definitely a mid-range monster. Your medium range is basically going to be your home with this. Up close, you're going to find yourself getting a little bit outgunned by a lot of things like submachine guns and, of course, sidearms. And because this gun requires about 3 to 4 bursts to kill up close, that's just not really viable. You kind of want to stay back a little bit with this thing and keep things comfortably in mid-range. This, of course, puts you into direct competition with auto rifles. And, you know, some of those high-caliber rounds auto rifles can definitely still, even with the nerf, cause a little bit of trouble. But I found this thing performs pretty well up against those class of weapons. The high stability on this gun, mixed with the ability to, of course, get its own ammo back and heal, is definitely something you're going to find a lot of use for in PvP. At this gun's optimal range, it deals about 21 to the head and 16 to the body. And it's got a pretty sizable effective damage range, so you should be seeing those numbers in most of your encounters with this weapon. And it's going to take, depending on armor, about 3 to 4 bursts to get a kill. With an optimal time to kill of about 1.13 seconds on low armor targets and 1.43 seconds on high armor targets. And while this gun's optimal time to kill isn't great, it's got such a large effective range and such a great ability that it kind of makes up for it. But you will want to pick your shots and maintain some distance in order to make the most of this gun. Overall, I really like the Crimson. The gun's got great base stats and a fantastic ability that, in my opinion, puts it on the level of a lot of the exotics from Destiny 1, which is something we're sorely lacking in Destiny 2 right now. And while it's not a busted Prometheus lens that's terrorizing the Crucible right now, it is a lot of fun to play with. So, I can't wait to get my hands on it on my own account. But alright, Guardians, that's it for our review of the Crimson Exotic Hand Cannon. Have you Guardians picked it up? Be sure to let us know what you all think of it down in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, feel free to drop a like and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date with all of the latest Destiny 2 news, information, reviews, guides, and everything else. But I'm out for now. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, I am the Black Link. You Guardians, stay frosty.